Did you guys just see that? Did you just see that? That is a rare, unseen image exclusively for the members of the My Muscle Academy. I appreciate you guys because you want the truth. You want to know about mastery, the history of bodybuilding culture, so that we can help move it in the right direction. So I appreciate you being here. And let's get right down to what this photo says. Venice, California, 1975. This picture was taken right after Arnold and Jeff Bridges made the movie Stay Hungry. There, Arnold played a weight of 210 pounds, so as not to appear too imposing for non-bodybuilding audience. Now, he was about to start training for the 1975 Mr. Olympia, pumping himself rapidly to a contest weight of around 240 pounds. Strange things happen as fashions change. If you see Jeff Bridges in a movie today, you'll notice he's put on about 25 pounds of muscle. Franco Colombo, the third man in the picture, and the greatest personal trainer on earth, as Sylvester Stallone, always takes credit for being Jeff's inspiration. George Butler, 1975. So, this photo is saying so many things, but most importantly, what we're seeing here is the cultural jumping off point. This is the launch pad of bodybuilding, the catapulting of this hardcore, freakish underground sport into the mainstream media like people have never seen before. They've never seen bodies like this. Bodies like this had not existed in the media before this point in 1975. So, Stay Hungry is this awesome point for Arnold Schwarzenegger because you see that he's now morphing his body to what the audiences want to see. You see that he is now working on entertainment as well as being this business professional and this top bodybuilder in the world. He also wants to take this to the masses. And you see that Franco Colombo is kind of still operating from the underground as this personal trainer who later becomes a chiropractor who is training stars like Sylvester Stallone, who popularized the physique possibly even more than Schwarzenegger. He is extremely influential, and it's all coming from this core group of guys training in Venice, California in 1975. You see Jeff Bridges here, and a lot of you young heads, a lot of you younger bodybuilders that are tuning into this content, you may not even know who Jeff Bridges is, but he is one of the greatest actors ever. So here it says he put on about 25 pounds of muscle, and now he's a big fat guy who's still this amazing talent, but you see the evolution of him as an artist from this skinny lean guy to this bigger guy to this fatter guy, all doing this really just iconic job as an actor throughout his whole career. So that's a lot of what's going on here. Why this photo is important to me is because it's shot on film in black and white photography, and it was given to me by the photographer who shot a lot of my magazine covers and a lot of the best athletes in the world's magazine covers as well. And I am now lucky to call him a friend and a confidant today. But I look at my own career and I see how we kind of bridge that gap of still working on film and creating this really cool, classic, aesthetic bodybuilding physique as it's evolved into this social media world that we see today. Anyway, this photo is just awesome. It's funny, it's cool, and it's just epic, legendary bodybuilding. I got one more for you guys because I never disappoint here at the My Muscle Academy. And this is Arnold Schwarzenegger very early in the morning. Schwarzenegger, Gold's Gym, George Butler, 1973. And for those of you that don't know George Butler and what that story is, you can see that this is a real authentic photograph from George Butler, and he is the creator of pumping iron. So if it wasn't for George Butler, we wouldn't have this cultural influence we have from bodybuilding, where he was raising money and capturing amazing photography. Someone had to be that person in that vehicle to drive the whole culture into this. So he actually held a bodybuilding exhibition where he had the top bodybuilders in the world posing on rotating stages like statues to generate revenue to make pumping iron a reality and make Arnold a star. So he believed in Arnold before everybody else. I'm not going to go into the full history of their relationship right now, but it's all very interesting stuff. And this is truly the origins, the engendering, the creating of bodybuilding as we know it today. So really cool stuff. You look at Schwarzenegger's face here and it just says, you know, I'm paying my dues. It just smells of hard work and grit and dedication, but still cocky and confident and hopeful for the future. So this is just a awesome, true golden era moment preserved for us here, and it's just badass. So thank you guys for tuning in to me today. If you want the exact workouts of how to look like a bodybuilder from the classic time, that golden era bodybuilding physique, paired with that warrior agility and mobility and training like a martial artist and a bodybuilder, head over to justinwoltering.com, check out the My Muscle Academy, and I look forward to seeing you on the inside. Peace, fellas.